Hi, Cub Scout people. My name is Joey Bland. I am the Cub Master of Pack 7 in South Pasadena, and today I'll be your guide through a wolf adventure that's called Collections and Hobbies. It's a very straightforward title for what it is. It's about collections and hobbies, mainly the collections parts. This is a pretty simple one. There's no real hard demonstrations to do. There's not much I can show you on what to do, but I'll still kind of take you through the steps real quickly. Requirement number one for collections and hobbies is to have a collection or to start a collection. What you want to do is find 10 things at least that all share something in common and make that into your collection. Maybe you already have one. I put one out here right now. This is our family's collection of mythological creatures and monsters. We started collecting these when my kids were really, really young. They got one as a toy, and then we just add one or two every year. They're fun, and we can talk about the stories behind them. You know, Hercules killed the Hydra, and so we can play with those. But that's fun. And what you want to do with your collection, what I did was I labeled everything nicely. And that's part of the requirement, actually, is to label them. So you want to present it. You want to set it up so it's nice. It's not just a shoebox full of your stuff, but lay it out. Make it into a museum. Another thing we've collected in recent years, right below here, below our myth creatures, as we call them, are scouting event patches, and I bet you started collecting some of those yourself. I didn't label these because they're sort of self-labeled anyway. So what you want to do is start a collection or organize your collection, label it nicely, and you want to put on a show with it. And that leads right into requirement number two, which is to share your collection with your den. Now that might be a challenge during social distancing and quarantine times, but if your den is meeting online, great. Maybe you are meeting in small groups with appropriate safety precautions, and you could still show off your collection to your den. Next, requirement number three. Three has two parts, and you only have to do one of them. Part one is to go to a museum that showcases collections, or to a collection show. Now, again, if you can't get out to something, if the rules say you can't be in a museum or museums are closed, if you want to practice safety precautions, if you have to do that, then you probably can't do that first part. But maybe you can soon enough. Some things are loosening up. If you can't do 3A, go to a museum, you can do 3B, which is to look online for a webcast or a video about the same kind of thing, showcasing collections. And there's actually a YouTube playlist in the lesson plan that is attached to this. And it is built by not by me, but by Scout people who put together a list of videos about collections and hobbies specifically for this adventure. Included in there is a video about collecting scouting patches. So great, watch some of those, get an idea of other people's hobbies and their collections. So that brings you to the final requirement, which is requirement number four. And just like three, you have to do one of two parts. Now, part one, 4A, which is one of the options, is to start an autograph collection. And it says in the book, start with your den. Now, if your den's not meeting in person, it's going to be hard to get signatures. Maybe you have a nice big family and you're seeing a lot of people and you can get a lot of signatures into your book. This is just a blank book I have. You could even make one of these, just staple some papers together, no big deal, and go around and get people to sign it. Maybe write you a message and sign it. Again, this could be a challenge, but if you're looking for someone to start your collection, you know what? I'll be your first autograph. I'll make this out specifically to you. So to you, and I'll sign it right there. Joey Bland. As messy as I could do with a dry erase marker. Frame that, screenshot it, print it out, cut it up, put it in your book. There's your first autograph, how special that is, and almost legible. So the last thing is we want to go back to, that's 4A. The last piece is 4B. So if you can't do the autograph book, you can do this one instead. Nice, gives us a little bit of room. 4B is to write a letter to someone asking for their autograph. And the idea is to write it to someone famous or someone of note, someone that you admire or entertained by. There's a good sample letter in your book, or I wrote this one up, which is to my fake favorite movie star, Chaz Razmataz. And so if you just follow along, there's a date at the top, and then I would put Chaz Razmataz's address right under that. Of course, he lives at 123 Movie Star Street in Hollywood. And then I'm just going to write a nice letter, friendly. Tell them why I'm writing this letter. I'm writing this letter to let you know what a big fan I am of your movies. My favorite movie you've been in is Super Fast Cars. I love the part where you drove that car super fast. I also like Super Fast Cars 2 and Super Fast Cars 4. On and on, I'd give a little details about what I liked. And I also mentioned, I said I'm also a Cub Scout, and writing this letter is part of working on my wolf badge. It would mean a lot to me if you would send me a photograph with your autograph on it. And to that end, what I also put on in there is that I would enclose a self-addressed stamped envelope. That's one way to make it a little easier for them. If you can put an envelope in there with your address and they can send you your autograph. Now, a lot of famous people will do that for you, and it might take a lot of time. They might not send it to you. When I was a kid, I wrote a fan letter to Michael J. Fox, the star of the Back to the Future movies, and I didn't get anything back. But it didn't mess up my love for those movies. And you know what I did was just what you have to do, which is I did my best. Good luck.